Okay, we're over at the People's Gym, Kieran Farrell's headquarters. Very pleased to be joined by Kieran Farrell and his boxer Darryl Sharp. Now we've been doing like a bit of a journeyman corner. We got the Quinny and Willie Warburton recently and Gigano, yeah, Curtis. And it wouldn't be a good journeyman corner without getting Darryl Sharp on it, because Darryl, you know, you're one of the busiest fighters in the country. I mean, you're fighting every week. I'm sure if it was up to you, you'd probably fight every night. But you know, you're all over the show. You're fighting this Saturday. You know, we were saying there, like, originally your first fight, you was given a handful of tickets by ourselves, really. But you'll sell them, and you know, you might get paid, and then you had the option of being the away opponent, selling your tickets and getting paid, and that's sort of the reality of a journeyman. When did it sort of click to you then that this
was
is
that
what
moment?
I'm
gonna do? When I saw them tickets, I was asked to kill him, didn't I?
Yeah.
Him, he said he told me about the prices of stuff. And I said, I texted back then, I was like, what about me? Then obviously I realised I was
going to blue corner then, didn't it? We're going away corner.
So all the tickets you might get paid,
when he had his debut, he was in the home corner and he was like, fucking hell, kids, where's my grand? I'm like, gotta do your tickets, bro, you know what I mean? And obviously we had the Mid-Arena one coming up, and then we left it a few months, and we had his debut October the 31st, 2015. Didn't fight then till March 2016, which was the Black Flash show against Aaron Michael. And we, like I say, when you said, here's your tickets, get rid of them and you might get paid this and you might not get paid at all, or you can go in the blue corner and fight Aaron and you're gonna get paid your grand. You're like, fucking get me that blue corner, obviously.
Never left that blue corner ever since.
It's mistake there.
And you've not stopped fighting ever since.
No.
You know, being where you are fighting every week, you know, obviously you get fighters who are, you know, I won't fight unless I've had an 8-week camp or a 10-week camp or that kind. You know, is your camp just ongoing?
Life.
Yeah, just every day, really. Yeah,
it's life.
You know, just work and train straight after work every day. You're just ready for a fight tonight, every week, so.
Yeah, look, I think it takes a, it's like, look, Mike Orban, he's got going nowhere, because I've 3 fights, lost them all. He's boxing on the road. Don't fucking cry about it, you know what I mean? We know the situation. Yeah. Even if you have a close fight, you might not get the nod, you know. But look, Mike, he started out his debut on the Sky Sports Dylan White undercard, which were buzzing, was like happy days, you know what I mean? Because like, it could go either way, obviously. You never know how fight is going to take to the professional game, and he fought a kid who had his debut, Louis Linney, who called English ABA champion, a good kid. Obviously he was good, he signed with Eddie Hearn for his pro debut, and Mikey got stopped in that fight, and he had his little rest tonight. He was devoured, he got 45 days, he weren't really badly hurt, he was alright, he was on his feet when he got stopped, it's just kid was just too good for him, you know what I mean? And then anyway, he learned from there that what he had to do and stuff like that, and I said, look, you're not at that level, you're not Darryl Sharp's level yet, where you come in once and twice a week and do your little bit of training. I said, you got to train hard, you bro. I said, you got to work hard now, make sure you put it in. They come back anyway, had a 6-pack, ripped up and everything. He's like, yes, I'm ready for my fight. He fought last Saturday and the Saturday before, and he's there now, where he's coming in tomorrow. And we might get a phone call on Friday and say, look, we've got Mike Kirby. And he's like, yeah, of course we have, you know what I mean? How much are you going to pay him, you know what I mean? So that's that. Boxing on the road is its own beauty and it's its own art. And I take me out off to any fighter who gets in the ring, but more so for the lads who box in the away corner now. Like, say, on 22nd of June, Darryl Sharp, who's an away fighter, is fighting another away fighter, Harry Matthews, two lads who they've picked up the wins on the road and both can fight. And they're both fighting for the area super middleweight title. Buzzing, mate. Darryl's gonna knock him out, aren't you, bro?
I mean, a lot of the fights you go in, you have to get your head around the fight. You're going in to lose, and you know, let's be real. I bet there's a few times you've held some of them up.
You
could finish this, and you could. But there's a prospect he sold all the tickets. How did you get your head around that kind of thing? When you could win, you have to maybe not go out all hell out and knock him out.
It took us a while.
I said to Chris before, I said, look, remember, sometimes I said, Darryl come back smiling after fucking putting a combination together and nearly knocking them out. And I'm like, mate, it's up to you. You won't fight next week. You get a win, but you won't fight next week. And then obviously he'll go out there and, you know, he'll just have to move around and do his thing and make sure that he's not fucking turning these prospects over half the time, you know what I mean? It's madness.
And now and again, I mean, there has been a few fights where you've gone in full pelt. I mean, the ones with Matthew Ryan, you've gone in to win them. They were local derbies, title on the line, well, you won the central area title.
Yeah.
I mean, I watched you beat John Telford in an upset. You know, I mean, John's a good fighter. I think he had an off night there as well, but he's not that
fucking... Fuck,
looked
that,
like
fuck,
I beat him,
nothing
away from story.
Him. Hey, can't come to the people as
you. What he said?
Did you go for that win on
he had an interview and he went, I felt like I was underwater. No, it's because I fucking cracked you.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
No, 100%. Look, Chris, you can't come in here and start saying he had an off night. Fuck you, I've got a fucking Darryl Sharp fucking beat him up, mate. That's what happened. So I watched it, I was at home, I was in Belfast, I had my show the night after, and I was watching it. I thought, you know what, you're going to fucking get robbed here. And I said, when they said, 38, 37, like, no fucking way was it 38. He got fucking hammered, mate, you know what I mean? And he fell fucked up, he got the nod for it.
I was at that fight, yeah, of course you deserve to win it. Absolutely. But that's what I'm trying to say. Some, you know, you're going there sometimes against someone who's, you know, not as good as a certain opponent, but you'll turn it on when you have to.
Yeah.
That night you turned it on.
Yeah, that
kind of thing. And then other times you're going against someone who's not as good as John Telford, and you know, you sort of take
it's
the loss.
That's the way it works, isn't it? Really, like. It's just how it is, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
So, like, getting yourself up for the certain fights, like that one with John and the ones with Matty Ryan and that kind of thing, is it just, you know, you turn it on when you have to?
No, like, in some fights, you've more fired up for than other fights as well.
And I think a lot of it's to do with it when he's boxing every week as well. Sometimes he might be a bit lethargic 1 week, you know what I mean? And he's had to drain his weight down and could bring it back up, and then he fucking we get a phone call, can he make 12-7? Like, fucking 11 stone 6, but fuck it, yeah, we'll have it, you know what I mean? And we'll go in. Darryl don't give a fuck, he'll fight anyone. You know what I mean? If I said he's a cruiserweight fight, he'll fucking get a bit of cake down him and we'll have it, you know what I mean? In that arse, you know. So I think that's got a lot to do with it as well, obviously, with the fluctuation in weight and stuff like that. You're never going to be at your fucking supreme self, are you? You know what I mean? Like I say, draining weight, putting weight on, and you know, but he's got to go where the work is, and look, it's a good little fucking living for him, you know what I mean? It's happy days.
Yeah. I mean, not only going in, you're getting Dane's notice, aren't you, at some time? Yeah, you know what I mean? Look at, you're not only going in with young prospects, hey, look at Liam Williams.
Saturday with the best one. So he gets in with Fred Evans, who's a GB kid. And this is our day's notice. It was a day's notice, wasn't it? Day's notice. And he got in there and he made easy work of it. Like, this Fred Evans is a top kid. And Daz got in there and made easy work of getting the job done. Like, and the job done doesn't mean that he beat him up. The job done was, we got in there and he was in no way, shape or form in any trouble at all. He just got in there, gave him a few feints, covered up, tucked up, hit him every time. We had the game plan Burma, didn't we? Every time Darryl backed up, he had to come in, and every time he come in, he went, boom, right up, and you caught him, didn't you, bro? You know what I mean? So, he's doing this with a GB fighter, you know, who's just turned professional, and he's this top kid who's 6-0 with 4 knockouts and that. I was getting in there making them look like they're not that good, you know what I mean, when they really are that good. So if you put any other kid in with that what's it called? What was it called?
Yeah.
I just
Fred
said
Evans.
Fred Evans. If I put any other kid in with Fred Evans that night, Fred Evans would have sorted them out, you know what I mean? But Darryl made it look a bit easier than it should have been, you know what I mean? So fair play to Darryl, I say, you know, I take me off because I had 15 pro fights himself. Darryl's fucking a veteran, mate. He's had treble, you know what I mean?
What's the
show
taking, took a fight?
A day, I think it was.
The Jimmy Kelly, the Liam Williams
rounds,
fight. The Liam Williams fight, that was fucking a day's notice. That Fred Evans fight, that was only a day's notice as well, you know what I mean? It just goes on.
You're always
on,
training,
you know?
Though, like all the gym, I'll tell you, like, you're always in the gym.
I always say as well, this sort of saying about all the lads who've been here, like Sam Amida, Mike Orbin, Daz. The lads, I just say, look, you stay on it, you know what I mean? You have your day off after your fight, it's fine. Don't put fucking £10 on, that's stupid, you know what I mean? Because if a phone call comes and you can't take it, then you'll be gutted and you've lost out, you know what I mean? Whereas, like you say, they're all in and around the weight and stuff like that. And they're learning the game, you know what I mean? And that's what it's about, them learning, and they're making a good life for themselves out of professional boxing. Something what these prospects all cry about. But mate, if you want to fucking make some money out of professional boxing and you're not signed to Eddie Hearn, and you've not got ambitions of fucking boxing for titles and stuff like that, then you've just got to do what you've got to do. And look, Darryl, fair fucks to me, like I say, got in there, like, where's my grand? Get in there, we'll fight every weekend. You know what, we really enjoy it. I enjoy it probably more with the fucking, with the away fighters, because we have a laugh all the time, you know what I mean? It's just a fucking, it's like the boys go out, have a laugh down there. Yeah, isn't it, mate? And so even when you get in an Eddie Hearn show, your matchroom look after you, or you get fucking hotels, 5 stars. It was in the jacuzzi. It was in the jacuzzi chilling, and it was good, mate. You know, and we think, fucking hell, how the fuck did life get so good for us? You know? It's funny, mate.
No, is that Liam Williams fight, obviously you're fighting the up-and-coming prospects, but going in against someone who's a former British champion, that level, could you sort of see, it a big step up? The last few fights, did you think, yeah, it's a bit different?
It's just the way he picked the shots, and like how he picked it is good. Like, it's different, you could tell. Weren't your average fighter, anyway.
Yeah, really, just tell that difference. Yeah.
And the way he landed him as well, like, it's different, completely different than your prospects or something like that. Yeah. But it's what it is, isn't it? Like,
I mean, if you looked at your record, you've probably been in with all the prospects around your weight, you know, coming through. You know, any of them stand out for you? Any of you been in and fought this guy? The young sort of up and coming, you know, ones who have had, say, less than 10 fights. Where you've had to be on your game to survive, if you like, you know.
Jack Sellers, I've always rated him, don't I?
Yeah, since Jack Sellers, him. Yeah.
There's loads of this Kieran Smith,
we got in there. Yeah, we got told it was 11-1 or something like that. He got in there, mate. It looked like fucking Cassius Clay, mate. Dancing around him, fucking massive, mate. And fair fucks to Daz again. Look, I think Kieran Smith ended up knocking someone's spark out like a week later, live on Sky Sports, and Ricky Burns on the card. Darryl got in there, got through the 4 rounds, but he said to me, I went, I'm baiting them body shots, so he just exited the area, boom, 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 like that. And nah, the fucking headshots, I went, oh, shit. I went, I don't know what to say, Daz, just keep fucking doing this, you know what I mean? No, what the fuck do you say tonight, you know what I mean? Get the fuck away from
No, I mean, one of the things you've probably learned to survive, you learn all the tricks and you pick them up, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, you've been pro 3 years or something now, but you pick up all the little,
yeah, 3 years, yeah.
Little surviving tricks. And
yeah, you pick them as you go every fight, like, you learn something new, so.
It's so, nothing, it's like I say, even with me, Chris, I've been fucking doing this boxing game fucking years now, since I was 7 years old, and there's so much to learn, and then even with professional boxing, I've been in the professional boxing game since I was 18, so 2008, so 2018, now 10 years, and anything, you know what I mean, I still feel like a novice myself, you know what I mean, I know my shit, but not everything, you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm. You've got a good chin as well. I've seen you take some serious. I mean, you know how to survive, but you can take a punch. Never been on the floor, still.
Never would.
No. Yeah. No. And it's quite amazing when you think of you.
Mate, look, I'll be honest, as I was saying, you never got me down, mate. You never got me down.
Not pain, no. Yeah, well, he's you know, certainly a fighter in your image, getting with anyone, and. You know, and long may it continue. People always say, you know, journeyman, if you like, or the away fighter, whichever way you want to say it, you know, the life of the sport. Some of these lads won't get fights if we want for people like you having the ball to get in there last minute with anyone.
The lads are running the game, the boys in the away corner are running the game, and that's simple as that, you know what I mean? There would be no boxing now if it weren't for them, and that's what they say. These are proper, true professional fighters, these, you know what I mean? So they're fucks enough to make a few quid, and so be it, you know what I mean? They deserve it.
Do you think there'll ever come a time when you think, you know what, I'm gonna give it a couple of years where I'll try and win a few fights and get a title shot and see how far I can take it, and maybe
it's my second title shot on the road.
No fucking money in it, is there, bro?
No, it's
or what if
I reckon I'm gonna try and aim for the 100 fights, and then I'll probably I can keep going, but
is that you want to get to 100 fights?
Yeah. That's what you said, isn't it?
Easy work, bro.
So it goes from there.
What are we on now? 40, I think it is.
40, yeah.
That's mad, isn't it? Yeah.
Mate, 40, we're going to be 2-time area champion. Yeah. Fuck, we don't need to go in the fucking home corner to get the fucking title, and we'll pick them up anyway, corner.
It could be one of them.
Better watch out.
It could be like one of them Rocky stories, or, you know, you get your shot one time, so the champion pulls out, and it's a big fight at the MEN, and you step in and
get that win.
Pound for pound, number one.
A bit like Liam Williams,
turn around.
You have to sit the fucking hell on him to not get a win over him, bro, you know? After all these leg with corner, what does it him now?
No, it's great. It's always you know what I think. It's always great to see you and catch you and you know, top fella as we know, Kieran. So good to see you, lads. God bless. Good luck this Saturday. Who have you got this Saturday?
Dalton Miller.
Dalton Miller.
Get beat up.
Dalton Miller. How many has he had?
14, he's won 6 last 8 and he's having it, mate, isn't he?
Yeah. Are we going for it?
Yeah, so you get a nice little win before Harry Matthews, yeah, 100%. So he's having it.
Good luck.
Yeah, fuck you, mate.
Right, training's to be done, so.
Alright.
Catch up soon.
Nice and crisp.